Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to put your name onto a Broadway marquee. I provided this image for you to download so you can follow along. Its link is located in the video's description or project files. In addition, I included a link to the font Clubland, which we'll be using for the sign. If you're not sure how to install fonts, watch my tutorial showing how to do it. I provided that link as well. Create a new document by going to File and New. Make the size 1000 by 390 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Make sure the color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Click the arrow to open the background contents and click Other. Pick Black and then click OK on both windows. Press Ctrl or Command 0 to fit it onto your screen. Open your horizontal type tool and open Clubland. I'll make the size 100 points. Choose a size that will comfortably fit all the letters of your name. Make it smooth and left alignment. Click the color box and pick a color. I'll type in FF00DE. No matter what color you pick now, we can always change it later. Type out your text. To center it on your document, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A, and then click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command D. Make a copy of the text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Double-click on the large T of the copy to highlight the text. Click the color box and pick white. Click off the eyeball next to the original text to hide it and go to Filter, Stylize, and Wind. When you see this window, click OK to rasterize the text. The method is wind and the direction is from the right. Click OK and press Ctrl or Command F 3 times to repeat the filter 3 times. Go back to Filter, Stylize, and Wind, and this time tick from the left. Click OK and press Ctrl or Command F 3 times. Go to Image, Image Rotation, and 90 degrees clockwise. Press Ctrl or Command F 3 times, and then go back to Wind and tick from the right. This time, press Ctrl or Command F 2 times. Go to Image, Image Rotation, and 90 degrees counterclockwise. Drag the top layer below the text. We'll merge these two layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Gradient tool and make sure the Linear Gradient icon is highlighted. Click the Gradient bar to open the Gradient Editor. Click on the Spectrum preset and click OK. Go to the lower left corner of the image and drag the line to the upper right corner. Change the blend mode to overlay. Make the text visible and active. Click the FX icon and click Inner Glow. Click the color box, pick white, and click OK. Change the blend mode to normal and increase the opacity to 100%. The source is center and the size is 7 pixels. Click Outer Glow. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, the spread is 100%, and the size is 9 pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Next, we'll add a slight outer glow to the light bulbs. Make a copy of the text and reduce the fill to 0. Click off the eyeball of Inner Glow to hide the effect and double-click on Outer Glow to open it in the Layer Style window. Click the color box and type in the same color as your text. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 75%, the spread is 0, and the size is 3 pixels. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. To change the color of your sign, click on the Adjustment Layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Slide the hue to the left or right. Since I already have the color I like, I'll trash the adjustment layer. Let's place the text layers into a folder. Shift-click on the bottom text to highlight both layers and press Ctrl or Command G. Let's name it Text. Next, we'll add a vignette around the inside perimeter of our sign to soften the edges. To do this, make a composite snapshot of the image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Double-click on the layer to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow and the color box. Pick Black and click OK. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 75%, the source is edge, the choke is 0, and the size is 50 pixels. Then, click OK. Make another composite snapshot. Press V to open your Move tool, and drag your sign onto the tab of the Broadway marquee photo. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the photo and release. Next, we'll fit the sign onto the white shape of the marquee. We could use the vanishing point filter to put it in the same perspective as the marquee, but for this example, it's much quicker and easier to use the transform tool. To open the transform, press Ctrl or Command T. Drag it over the marquee and go to the corner. Press and hold Ctrl on Windows or Command on a Mac as you drag the corner of the transform to the corner of the white shape. Continue to press and hold Ctrl or Command as you drag each corner of the transform to the corners of the white shape. If you see any white fringe around the sign, continue to press and hold Ctrl or Command as you move the corners of the transform to cover the fringe. Then, press Enter or Return. We'll adjust the sign's levels, grain, and sharpness to blend into the photo. Press Z to open your Zoom tool and drag it over the corner of the marquee to zoom into it. Press Ctrl or Command L to open your Levels window and in the black output level type in 25. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 4%, Gaussian, and uncheck Monochromatic. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 0.3 pixels. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.